Assalamu alaikum, dear students, and welcome you all for today's science class. Today's talk of the day is hard work is the key to success. It means that harder you work, the luckier you get. All great achievers of mankind worked hard in their fields, and success was a blessing in response to their dedication to their work. That's why hard work is said to be the most important key to success. Okay, now moving towards our today's lesson, right? Students, as you know, since the Bronze Age, about 4,000 years ago, people have been extracting metals from the earth. They have melted these metals to make tools, utensils, for their daily use, and weapons also to protect themselves from wild animals or from their enemies. So the story of metals is very old. People have been using metals since long. Metals are useful material even today in our everyday life, from window grills to cooking pots and to other means of transport. So the topic for today's lesson is properties of metals. Right? Before starting to discuss the properties of metals, firstly, you should know what is a metal. A solid material, which is typically hard material, hard, shiny, with good electrical and heat conductivity, is called a metal, right? What is a metal? It is an element that is usually a solid shiny conductor, or you can define it, a metal is a solid material which is hard, shiny, with good electrical and heat conductivity, is called a metal. Examples of metals are iron, gold, silver, aluminium, copper, zinc, lead. And there are so many other examples, right? So let's discuss the properties of metals now. First property of metal which we are going to discuss is that metals are lustrous. What does lustrous mean? Lustrous means shiny, something that shines brightly and gently, is called lustrous. Metals have brilliant shine, called luster. For example, gold, copper, silver, iron, they have all of these metals have lustrous appearance. Gold and silver used in jewelry. Why? Because of its lustrous nature. Why metals are lustrous? This is because of free electrons present in the metal structure, right? In metal structures, in metallic structures, free electrons, they are present. These free electrons, they move freely, causing any light fall on them to get reflected back. This reflection of light is smooth. That's why the metals, they appear shiny, right? So see this example of a cloud gate. This is a picture of cloud gate sculpture. It is also known as the beam sculpture. It is in Chicago, America. This structure is made up of highly polished stainless steel plates, right? It is made up of highly polished stainless steel plates, which reflect skyline and the beauty of sky, and is the biggest attraction for the visitors there. Clear? Okay. Now, see this video clip. Then we will discuss the next property of metal. So you have seen this video clip, and we will discuss the property of metal, that is sonorous, right? Metals, they are sonorous. What does sonorous mean? The word sonorous means capable of producing a ringing sound when hit, as you have seen in the video. When you hit the metals, they produce ringing sound. That's why metals, they are called that they are sonorous. Sonorous means capable of producing ringing sound when hit. Clear? And this property, it helps to allow the metals to make different types of things, like metals they are used for making bells, metals they are used in the strings of guitar, right? And the strings of guitar, these bells, they are made up of metals and they produce high degree, deep ringing sound. Clear? Okay, now moving towards the next property of metals, that is metals they have high density. Metals they have high density. As you know that metals, they have closely packed structure, right? As you see here that this is the metallic structure. I'm flashing light over here, this picture. So this is this metallic structure or the structure of a metal. So in metals, they have closely packed atoms. Metals, they have closely packed structures, having closely packed atoms in their structure. So there is very, very little space between the atoms. That's why the metals, they have high density. Metals, they have high density because of their structure, because of their closely packed structure. Clear? Atoms in the metallic structure, they are closely packed, right? Which makes them highly dense. That's why the metals, they have high density. And that's why the metals, they are very heavy. Clear? Density of copper, it is about 9 grams per cubic centimeter. And density of gold is about 20 grams per cubic centimeter. So you see in this picture, if the material is high, has high density, then the structure would be like that. But those materials which have low density, their internal structure would be like that. There are lots of spaces in between their atoms. But the metals, they have high density, that's why they are closely packed and they have closely packed atoms in their structure. Clear? Now moving towards the next point or next property of metal, that is metals, they have high melting and boiling point, right? This is again because of this, their structure, because of the structure of the metals, that metals, they have high melting and boiling point, right? As you know that metals are giant lattice or crystalline structures, right? Metals, they have crystalline structures. They have giant crystalline structure or lattice structure, which means, what does lattice mean? It means that at the metals, they have closely packed structure, right? And these closely packed structures, they are having strong bonds between the atoms. They have strong bonds between the atoms. As they are closely packed, why they are closely packed? Because of the strong bonds present between the atoms. That's why metals, they have high melting and boiling point, right? That's why metals, they have high melting and boiling point. As you see examples of metals, you see the copper wires. We usually use copper wires in electric cable. Right? Why do we use copper wires in electric cable? Because of its strength, because of the good flow of electricity through them without heating and without melting, right? because these wires they have, or these metals they have, metallic wires have high melting and boiling point because of its strength, because of good flow, without heating, without melting, they are used in electric cable. Tungsten filament. There is another example of metallic filament or metallic wire that is used in the bulb. Metallic wire is used in the bulb. If you see in this picture, I'm flashing light over here. Metallic wire, a metallic filament is used in the bulb. That metallic filament is made up of a metal that is called tungsten. The tungsten filament is used in the bulb. When electricity passes through it, it gets red hot. It gets red hot and starts glowing, but it does not melt. When it glows, we see light from the bulb, right? Basically, tungsten is a strong metal. It is one of the toughest metal. It is super dense and hard to melt. That's why it is used in the bulbs also and lamps also. Because when electricity passes through it, it gets red hot. It starts glowing, but it does not melt. And when it glows, then we see the light coming from the bulb. So students, that's why tungsten is used for the filaments of light bulbs, right? Which provides a more consistent, longer lasting and high quality light to us. Clear? So metals, they play a big part in our everyday life. We interact with them differently as each of them has its own unique properties. Clear? And these properties are quite helpful for us in our daily life. Is it clear? Students, metals are tremendously important to a high energy society. They transport electricity in electrical grid and provide many services. So, in other words, we can say that metals are necessary to maintain society's modern standard of living. Clear? The electrical grid couldn't exist without copper and steel. You have seen the use of copper in electric wires, in electric cables. You have seen the use of tungsten filament in lighting bulb and lamps. So, it means that electrical grid couldn't exist without copper and steel. In fact, all areas of electricity production and distribution require metals. Clear? From turbines used to transform mechanical energy into electrical electricity to distribution stations that bring electricity to our homes, offices, and other buildings. Right? Okay, now I will move towards the next property of metals, and that property of metal is most metals, they are hard solids, right? Most metals are hard solids. Metals generally, they are hard in nature. For example, iron. Iron is used to make steel, which is used in making rail tracks, bridges, ships, surgical instrument, utensils, because of its strength and hardness, right? Because of the strength and hardness of the metals, they are used in making railway tracks, bridges, ships, surgical instrument, utensils, and in so many other things. Now the question is, why metals are hard? If this question comes into your mind, then the answer of this question is that metals are hard because of its structure, right? The answer is, again, because of the structure of the metals, because of the metallic structures, we can say that metals, they are hard. Clear? Metals are hard because their atoms are close together, because their atoms are closely packed together, because their atoms, they are arranged very close to each other and forming layers. Right? They are not present individually in the metallic structure. They are arranged or they are closely packed to each other and they form layers of the atoms, right, in the metallic structure. So it is quite difficult to break down metals into smaller pieces, right? It is quite difficult to break down metals into smaller pieces. Metals are a principal component building construction because of their strength. Strength is an important quality in the use of metals. Clear? So iron and steel are used in construction of railway tracks and bridges because of its high strength and durability. Clear? That's why we can say that metals, they are hard in nature. Clear? Okay. Students, what we had studied today is that metals are shiny or lustrous in their appearance. Clear? Then we had discussed today that metals, they have high density. The density is again because of the metallic structure, because of closely packed atoms in the metal structure. Then we had discussed today that metals, they are sonorous. Sonorous means metals, they produce deep ringing sound when hit, right? Dong sound, here the word dong is written. Dong sound means deep ringing sound when hit with a hammer, right? Then we had discussed that metals, they have high melting and boiling points. It means that metals do not melt easily, right? It's because it's again because of the structure of the metal atoms. It is again because of the closely packed structure, metallic structure having closely packed atoms, and that structure is having strong bonds between the atoms, right? That's why metals, they have high melting and boiling point. Clear? Okay, students, now if you have any query, any question regarding today's lesson, then you can ask now. Okay, now it's time to ask questions from you. Are you ready for question answer session? Good. Okay, my first question is that give four properties of metals. My next question is why metals are shiny. Next question is, what is the structure of atoms in metals? My next question is, why metals are dense? Next question is, what does sonorous mean? Next question is, explain why metals have high melting and boiling point. Okay, now it's homework time, right? And what is your homework for today? You have to do question answers of test yourself or unit 3, page number 31 from your book. And you have to do these questions on your science copies neatly and properly. So think and write question answers of page 31 of unit 3 neatly on your science copies. Clear?
Okay, students, today we had discussed few properties of metals. In next class, we will discuss few more properties of metals in detail. Right? So till then, goodbye from my side. Have a good day and thank you all for watching and listening.